field. Long run for Jim Edmonds. Oh, he made a catch! Unbelievable!
Jerry, that may be the best catch I have ever seen.
He looks at the left field. Going to be a tough play. Cheater on the run. Makes the play.
To left field, and it's another chance for Mitchell, and he makes a barehanded catch!
In my entire life, I've never seen that happen.
Well, look at that. I'm feeling you're not alone.
You gotta be kidding me.
Well, I'll tell you something. You heard the pre-game interview.
Gentlemen, good morning.
Morning, Mr. Oliver.
Good morning, Cameron. How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Just put those, thank you. I appreciate it. Seguin, how you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Good. Are you ready for today?
Absolutely.
Awesome. All right, gentlemen, let's not waste any time.
I finished the report last night.
You know those four pitchers that we've been looking at over the past month and a half? And I'm going to get you, Seguin, to just go over their physical attributes and sort it out for me. And
Larocque, I'm going to be getting you to sort through the profiles, okay? Shouldn't take too long.
I was actually wondering if I could throw a couple ideas out there. I've been doing my research, and I have a good feeling about a couple of players.
Okay. Listen, Larocque. Seguin and I, we've been in this game a very, very long time. And we kind of know the little things, you know, the little things that you look for in players and the red flags to avoid. And what I need you doing is going on that computer, finding the profiles, so Seguin and I can sort out who we're going to draft today. Okay?
He's got a good point there, Cammy. Need someone young running around grabbing his coffees.
Would you just read it? It's very detailed and I've been paying very close attention to the stats.
No. Did you not just hear Oliver? You'll get your shot, but in the meantime, listen to us.
Why do you talk to him like you're his little buddy? Even you don't get to make the final decisions on our picks. I'm just saying, I think I can have some valuable input on the team this year.
All right, big guy. Remind me again how many training camps you sat through this year?
I said I was willing to go. It was you specifically that didn't want me there.
Look, gentlemen. You see this clock? When that clock hits zero, it's not gonna care if we're ready or not. That clock is going to go on without us, without our readily intent, okay? When that clock strikes zero, the draft begins. And I came here today to be ready for when that clock strikes zero. And I ask you gentlemen today, did you come here to do the same?
Showtime.
All right, well, I think we need someone who can definitely lock down the middle infield. I don't know about you guys, but I don't want to be giving up any easy outs from a weak arm at shortstop.
Yes, I definitely agree. But you know what? I really like that kid from down south, the one from the international complex. Really throws the ball up in the shoulder. I mean, he's got work to do, but I see big league potential.
I'll see if he has any injuries on record.
Perfect.
Give me with that ball.
Yeah.
All right, what do you want?
Out of those pitchers that I did in the report, what'd you like? Anything catch your eye?
Yeah, I found this kid from Texas.
Okay.
Not the greatest season last year, but yep. I think he could really do something for us.
Finished it well. Good October.
Yeah.
Actually, speaking of that, Larocque, can you put up Seguin's PowerPoint up on the big screen?
No problem, boss.
Appreciate it. All right. Let me just go through this.
I think we should take the kid from the outfield. He's a five-tool player. Sees the ball.
The thing is, he's got bad hips, and yeah, he cuts through the ball, but he just doesn't see it well. Not enough to play at the major league level.
It says right here that he actually had a leg injury back in 2012.
He spent most of his college years on the DL.
It's a red flag right there.
Well, we evaluate our options then. But I know if he's healthy, he's going to score big for us.
Okay, well, has our medical staff, you know, done a record on him yet?
Cam, message their rep, see what's up.
Good. Ty, can you hand me that phone?
Yeah.
Larocque, I need you to hold that thought. Get me the number for Patterson.
On it. What, are you going to negotiate a trade with Patterson?
Well, listen, he completely undervalues his picks. And frankly, it would be a waste of our time to not at least try and lowball him. Okay?
Yeah, I like it.
Extension 4388.
Patterson, this is Oliver. I was hoping we can negotiate a little deal for ourselves tonight. All right, man.
Let's do this.
Listen, if Kimball dropped to 10th, are we taking him?
No.
Okay, then who are we going to get to bolster the outfield? We know that there's no prospects here anymore. Listen, I like big.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay, well, perfect. We didn't see that coming, but it doesn't really affect our game plan, okay? We stay on our toes. Just make sure.
If he drops, we'll take him. But we never know, okay?
Okay. Listen.
No surprise there.
Yeah, no sure.
Yeah. Saw that coming from a mile away.
Value them. They're looking to get us to bite. Are we taking the bait?
No.
Thank you, okay? Oh, we're gonna be taking Hugh Tyree.
I really like this kid. He's gonna be an everyday guy, if not more,
for sure.
Definitely a poor choice.
Yeah. Oh, fuck
my god.
Useless.
Useless.
Just months and
it's
months.
It's over. It's over.
So many hours down the drain. Okay, listen. We can't freak out.
Bring
we gotta
it together.
Stay calm.
Bring it together.
Get our players to out-hustle the competition. We don't have the biggest budget, too much time, and we've prepared too long to screw it up when the clock hits zero, okay? So let's focus on this, let's pay attention, and let's stay on our toes, okay?
Yeah, we'll take him.
Nice. Good job.
Okay, listen. Okay, make sure we stay ready because we're picking first in the next round, okay? Let's go.
What's going on? What the hell is going on?
Craig!
What?
How do you... Cameron, how do I get to the... Stop, stop.
It's pointless. Hey guys, did your draft snake... Oh, Christ, guys. What the hell is all this? These are school papers.
It's just...
Who the hell's Jason Biggs? Leave, Patterson. Okay, whatever, guys. But by the way, Craig, I'm pretty sure you decided to put us in a keeper's league. Did you not? Well, because what that means is, it doesn't snake. So next round, you guys are going last again. I'll see you guys in history.
It's just don't...
Oh, what do we do now?
I think we know what we have to do.
ESPN's online customer service. How may I help you?
Yeah, hi. My friends and I, we made a fantasy baseball league, and
okay.
we set the draft to snake between rounds, but it didn't do that, and the same person got the first pick in each round. So.
What's the name of the league?
It's
fantasy baseball for 10 grown men.
Yeah.
Okay. Just one second here.
I don't know if it was like a glitch or like a mishap in your servers, but if you could like reset it and maybe we could do the draft tomorrow with the snake, that would be awesome.
And is this a keeper's league?
Nope.
Oh, okay. That's strange. Give me one second to look into
this. That was a lie. Okay. It is. It's a keeper's league.
Yeah, sorry. You see, we make it so that keeper leagues don't snake for a couple of different reasons. If you read the small gray fine print at the bottom of the league registration page, you'll see that it specifies that if you have a keeper.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh.
Thank.
Okay.
Well, I gotta go hand my history paper in.
All right, see you again.
Yeah. All right, guys.
All right. I think I'm gonna head out too.
Hmm?
I think I'm gonna head out.
No. Okay.
All right. I'll see you there.
See you tonight. Are you going to history?
Yeah, I'll be in history.
Okay. Well, I'll see you in history.